Good morning, friends. So yesterday we started with a new chapter on coordinate geometry, and I hope by now you have a clear idea what coordinate geometry is. It is also called the Cartesian coordinate system by the name of the mathematician René Descartes. Okay. So what was that which I basically explained to you? If you remember, we had started with chapter number 5. Yes, introduction to Euclid's geometry. In Euclid's geometry, we saw that a point gives a location in space, say point A, point B, point C. These all are location in space. Now the distance between A, B, B, C, A, C can be find out if we have a technique to measure it. But that is the scope in the 10th standard, how to find the distance between the given points. For the 9th standard, what we have to do is, you can see this point A, B and C. So, are they on the same line? They are not. If you can draw a line between A and B, you can draw a line between B and C, you can draw a line between A and C. But A, B, C are not on the straight line. So, their coordinates will differ. So, basically I gave you yesterday the idea. So, I will do it again here. What was the idea? The idea was about the number line, right? Which you have done in the previous standard. So what is the number line? The number line indicates we have got a starting point which we call 0. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Positive numbers increasing to the right. Negative numbers decreasing to the left. Okay, so like I explained yesterday, you can have any point on this line. This is the point 2, this is the point 5, this is the point minus 2, minus 5 and so on. But on the board, when I draw a point, this is a two Cartesian system. What does the two Cartesian system mean? It means if you have a reference point, you move to the right and you even move to the top. Means you are changing by two dimensions. On this line, you may go to the right, you may go to the left, right, left, whatever, you only change one dimension. But sometimes you may go here. When you reach here, then you have changed two dimensions. From the origin, you have moved to the right, you have even moved to the top. Means two dimensions are changing, so we have a Cartesian coordinate system. So I did all this yesterday. This is the x-axis. X-axis is always horizontal, and then for the two dimension we draw one more number line, but this number line is vertical and we call this the y-axis. So we have got an x-axis and a y-axis. Together they are called the coordinate axis. Okay, so see the spelling A-X-E-S. Axis means singular is axis, y-axis, one axis. X-axis, one axis, plural is axis, A-X-E-S. So here also we have got a positive growth, which is indicated by the letters on the top, and a negative, which indicates the numbers below. Okay, so what you basically need to understand is here, why do we need a two coordinate system? And I gave you an example yesterday. Okay? Another good example is the chessboard. So people who play chess. Yes? A chessboard has got 64 squares. Alternate black and white. This is a rough diagram. I'm not counting the squares. But a chessboard is something like what? Alternate black and white squares. Okay? This is not the right diagram because there are 64 in the chessboard. But what you can see, if I take this origin, I can call this row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, row 5, row 6, row 7 and row 8. Okay? And column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, column 5, column 6, column 7, column 8. So there has to be a chessboard with 8 rows and 8 columns. Okay? So when you arrange your pawn. So suppose you have got a pawn here, you say. You have got a pawn here. Which is the position of the pawn right now? We call it R2 C1, second row first column. So we have got R2 C1. And suppose the pawn has jumped two steps. So we say it went from R2 C1 to this point. Which is this point? This point is R4 C1. So this I am giving you a very small example of a chessboard. People who play chess, so in the newspaper, in the Times of India before, I remember when I used to read the newspaper, they used to give some strategic positions and how to finish the game that was given. At that time, instructions were written like this, that from which block to which block something is moving. Suppose we say we have got a horse here. Okay, this is another example of a horse. And the horse is at which place? Row 1, column 7. Can you see? It is at row 1, column 7. And it can jump and go anywhere. So suppose the horse has reached here. The horse has reached here, right? So, the horse has reached here. Where it has gone? From R1 C7 to R3 C8. So how you can know how the horse has moved? You can say, the horse went two steps forward and one to the right, or you can say one to the right and two steps forward. You can move it both ways, you can call it. But in coordinate geometry, we view the x-axis first. So how much it moved to the right? One step. And how much it moved to the top? Two steps. So if it goes to the right, it is positive. If it goes to the top, it is positive. If it moves to the left, negative. So that is what we did in coordinate geometry. So I thought of this example of a chessboard. So in a chessboard, you have got 64 squares. Every square has got a specific location. So you can see R1, C1. You can also call C1, R1. R3, C4. You can also call C3, R4. But in coordinate geometry, we don't do that. Because what we have done here, now we will know what we have done. In this chessboard, I took C1, C2, C3, C4 up to C8. Right? And I took row 1 up to row 8. Now, suppose I have taken this one as C1, C2, C3, C4, and this I call minus C1, minus C2, minus C3, minus C4. This I call R1, sorry, I call this R1, R2, R3, R4, and I call this minus R1, minus R2, minus R3, minus R4. So you can call whatever you want. So what you can see here, now this point, which is the 0 here, and the 0 here becomes the origin. But this makes the game very difficult, so we do not use this method. Okay? So this was just for the chessboard. Don't go by the game, but what was it for? To show why two numbers are needed to show a specific location. So we have this coordinate system we did yesterday. So this is the x-axis, this end is called x, this end is called x prime, this end is called y, this is called y prime, and this is called O for the origin. So any point on the origin, like I told you yesterday, what are the coordinates of the origin? The coordinates of the origin are 0, 0. What does this first 0 indicate? The first 0 is on the x-axis. What does it indicate? The point is neither to the right, neither to the left. The point is not moved at all. It is where it was before. It is at the origin only, neither to the right, neither to the left, exactly in the center, 0. This point indicates it is neither to the top, neither at the bottom, exactly in the center, 0. Okay? So if you can see, yesterday we did this. This coordinate axis divides the plane into 4 parts. This we call the first quadrant, the second quadrant, the third quadrant, and the fourth quadrant. So coordinates here will be, both will be positive, moving right, moving up. This will be negative, moving left, but moving up. So this will be negative. So you have any point here is moving left, going up. So negative, positive. Any point here moving left, going down. So negative, negative. And any point here will be going right, coming down. So positive, negative. So this are asked in the fill in the blanks, true or false or whatever. So you understood? First the order of the quadrant. This is called the first quadrant. This is called the second, third, fourth. We are going anticlockwise. First, second, third, fourth. In mathematics, usually the anticlockwise direction is called the positive direction. So you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. Now, yesterday I also explained. Suppose I take a point 0, 5. 0, 5 has got one coordinate 0. So it is not on any quadrant. It will be on an axis. Suppose I take the point -3, 0. So when one coordinate is 0, the point will not be on the in the quadrant. It will be on the axis. Now what is 0, 5? 0 means the first point. So 0 means neither left, neither right, neither left, exactly in the center. So x is 0, but y is 5 means 5 steps higher. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 5. So this point is 0, 5. Means the point is on the y axis. So when the x coordinate is 0, the point is on the y axis. Now -3, 0 means 3 steps to the left. So -1, -2, -3, this one here, but top or bottom, none. 0 means neither to the top, neither below. So this is the point -3, 0. It is on which axis? X axis. So when the x coordinate is 0, the point is on the y axis. When the y coordinate is 0, the point is on the x axis. And if neither of them is 0, then it will be in some quadrant. So okay, I hope you can understand. 0, 0 means the origin. If one coordinate is 0, the point is on some axis. If x coordinate is 0, it is on the y axis. If the y coordinate is 0, it is on the x axis. But if none of the coordinates is 0, then it will be in some quadrant. So this is the first part. Now, the second part is for you to know by the graph paper. So what we are going to do now is a very small exercise. Yes, I will draw some points on the board here, and we will say the coordinates. Okay, so anyway, to write here, the first quadrant is called what? I told you x or y. What is the name of the second quadrant? X prime or y. What is the name of the third quadrant? It is x prime or y prime. What is the name of the fourth quadrant? It is x or y prime. So you can see the notification I told you yesterday. X is always written first. X means positive, y means positive. X prime negative, y positive. X prime y prime means both are negative and positive negative. Right? So this is what we get. So this is the only part we have to do here. And now the further chapters got only two steps to do. Only two questions from this chapter. One, if in a paper a point is given to you, you have to find out the coordinates. And two, if the coordinates are given to you, you have to plot that point on the graph. So graphs I will keep for later on. Right now, I will draw some points on the board and you have to give me the coordinates. Okay? So, I call this point A. I call this point B. I'll call this point C. I will call this point D. And let me call this point E. Let me call this point F. This point is G. This point is H. Okay, this point I call I, then this point I call J. Can you see it clearly? I would like to know if you can see it clearly. Yes, it is quite visible, right? So, I have drawn all the points. I give you 2 minutes to write out the coordinates. Okay, I'll wait for you. I give you 2 minutes, you write out the coordinates. And then I will write down the coordinates and we will compare the answers. So let me run this off now. We no longer need this. So you can, in the meanwhile, You can write down the So have you written it down? Then I will begin. Now how do we write the points? So what I am supposed to do? First you have to draw the foot of the point on the x axis. So when you draw the A down, where does it reach the point 3? So we will write 3. And when you bring the perpendicular on the x axis, where does it reach 2? So this point is 3, 2. Okay? Point B. First we draw the perpendicular to the x axis. What is the point? Minus 3. Then we drop it on the y axis. What is the point? 4. So it is minus 3, 4. Here is C. First we drop it on the x axis. So we get minus 6. Remember, x always stands first. And then you plot it on the y axis. What you get? Minus 2. C. D. Again, first on the x axis, so 4, and then on the y axis, so minus 1. So A is 3, 2, B is minus 3, 4, C is minus 6, -2, D is 4, -1, E. Can I plot it on the x axis? I cannot take it up, I cannot take it down, so this remains 0 because it is on the x-axis. No, x-axis means we have to plot it where? First on the x-axis. So if I touch the x-axis, it is on 2 itself. So I'll write 2. Now I bring it on the y-axis, but here it is 0, so the point is 2, 0. So I'll write on the top here clearly, point E is 2, 0. Point F. Okay, I try to touch the x axis, it falls on a 0, so it is 0, and the y axis it is at which point? At 3. F, G. G, first I drop the point on the x axis, so minus 3, and then I drop the point on the y axis, so again minus 3. G. Then H, if I drop it to the x axis, it is falling on exactly on 0. And the y-axis is at minus 5. I, in the same way, if I try to drop it on the x-axis, it is cannot be dropped on the x-axis, so this remains minus 4. But when I drop it to y-axis, this remains 0. H, I and J. J first I drop on the x-axis, so I get 2, and I drop it on the y-axis, I get minus 4. So this are the coordinates of the points. Okay, now from the coordinates we have to learn something called perpendicular distance. So let me take this point A whose coordinates are 3, 2. The point is A, the coordinates are 3, 2. Now this point, how much far it is from the x-axis? How much far? This much far? So, I say perpendicular distance from x-axis. How much true limit will be? What is the perpendicular distance from the x-axis? I hope it is clear on the board, you can see. Yes. What is the perpendicular distance from the x-axis? So, how much is this? So, we can see this forms a rectangle. This and this are equal. So, how many steps are this? 1. 2. So from the x-axis it is 2 units, and the perpendicular distance from the y-axis, how much is this far point far from the y-axis? So from the y-axis if you go 1, 2, 3, this is 3 from the y-axis. So here you see something has changed. When the point is 3, 2, means it is, this is the x-coordinate,
3 is which coordinate? X coordinate. But what does it mean? This x coordinate means it is 3 steps far from the y axis. And the 2 means it is at 2 units from the y axis. So what does the y axis give us? The y coordinate on the y axis. The y coordinate gives us distance from the x axis. The x coordinate gives us distance from the y axis. Also called the perpendicular distance. Why perpendicular? Because when you drop a line, it makes 90 degrees. So this is what we have to see. So listen carefully. For the MCQ, some tricky questions can be there. Distance from the x axis is the y coordinate. Distance from the x axis, is the y coordinate. And distance from the y axis is the x coordinate. Okay? So the distance is 2 units and 3 units. Now remember, and hope you already know, distance can never be negative. Can never be negative. So if they ask the question, the distance of this point from the x axis, then you know the answer is 4. But if they ask you the distance of this point from the y axis, how much far from the y, then you have got a coordinate minus 3. But distance is always positive, so distance will be 3. Remember it, this is very important to remember. The coordinates are that I told you. Distance from the x axis is the y coordinate 4. And distance from the y axis is the x coordinate minus 3. But distance is never negative, distance is always positive. So the question now can be asked in 2 different ways. And you have to read it properly and answer accordingly. So let me rub everything and keep only this thing on the board. Only one point. Okay? Now look at this point, minus 3, 4. Can you see? I am only stressing one question, minus 3, 4. And look at the question now, look at the words. Foot of perpendicular on x axis. Foot of perpendicular on x axis and perpendicular distance from x axis. Look at these two words very carefully. Because on your question, in your question, these words will be used and your answer will change accordingly. Now, what does the foot of the perpendicular mean? You can see this point minus 3, 4. So, draw perpendicular on the x axis. So, you draw perpendicular. What is the perpendicular? At 90 degrees. So, when this point you draw perpendicular, when you reach the bottom foot, so you reach the foot. What is the coordinate of the foot? Minus 3. Sorry, right here, minus 3. So, foot of the perpendicular on the x-axis is minus 3. But perpendicular distance from the x-axis, y-axis. Perpendicular distance from the y-axis is this distance. 1, 2, 3. Now, even though it is minus 3, the distance will be 3. So, look at the question carefully. If the foot of the perpendicular is asked, you have to write the coordinate. Foot of the perpendicular on x axis. So, if you see minus 3, the foot of the perpendicular on x axis gives you minus 3. But if the distance from the y coordinate, y axis there, the distance is 3 units. So, this is the only thing you have to remember. I think this is very easy now. When points are given to you, write down the coordinates. But this is the tricky part here. So this is all depending on the language, foot of the perpendicular or the perpendicular distance. So whatever is asked, that you are supposed to mention. Before we end the final summary, any point on the Cartesian plane is written in 2 numbers, a x coordinate and a y coordinate. So now any plane will be written in 2 numbers, okay? Any point in the plane will be written in 2 numbers. Can you see these 2 numbers? X, Y. Remember the order. The X coordinate always comes first. The Y coordinate always comes second. So this order has to be maintained. X and Y. So this is called the X coordinate. And I taught you yesterday, what is the other name for the X coordinate? It is also called Epsilon. Okay?
and the y coordinate is also called ordinate.
So this is only a name, nothing new. This is only the name given, a x coordinate and a y coordinate. Yes, it is the abscissa and the ordinate, only the name. So now you can start the exercise from the textbook. You can do the exercise. Which question you have to do? The question in which the diagram is given to you, the points on the graph are given to you, and you have to find out the coordinates. That's the first part. And tomorrow, if possible, be ready with the graph paper. We'll learn to plot the points on a plane. So this is quite an easy chapter. I hope you will like this chapter and will get the marks very easily. So I end here today and see you tomorrow.